Hello everyone, welcome. In this video, we're going to see how to make this interior of this car. So we're going to model this from scratch and making this interior and the front of this interior. So what I'm looking for is to make this interior not like it's realistic, but is a blueprint which is like a drawing or CAD drawing. And we will make two styles, one style which is realistic with materials, and the only style I'm looking for is the blueprint. And let's start. We will not making the outer parts, but also we will make the interior. So I'm not sure what how long this series will take, around 3-4 hours, no matter. So let's start from this lecture. So I have started your scene, and in the background we can apply and add background, but I have seen that it's this one, it has no projection, but it can may help. So let's start by applying and adding this picture in the background. So I have added this one, and this will be also in the front. If you go, you must be in the ortho mode to see this photo. If you go to any other view, you will not see this. Let's say in the right ortho, you will not see because it's only in the front. And you can also apply as many images, background images as you want, but I will use only one background image. So where is the screencast keys? So let's activate these screencasts, and let's say the text will be like this. And so let's start from this one, and the image is in the center. It may be better for other ones, but I will start to release this to up like this. And we will start from a cube, and shift A, add a cube, and take this cube to this size. And you can see that if I go to wireframe, you can see that the image in the perspective mode is wider. And I'm looking for, if you go to the size and the metric sizes, you can see that the dimensions of this cube is very large. And if you are going to model from scratch by using real sizes, so you can start, let's say that the wide for this car will be, let's say it will be 2 meters, so this cube will be in X will be 2 meters, and the height will be, let's say it will be 1 meter or 1.3, and the length, as you can see, maybe 3 meter or something like this. So we have make this cube, which is the real size, and we go to the background image and scale this down to match this cube. So let's match this cube by scaling down this image and height of this one, and it's better to and I can see that the size of 2 meter of 2 is good for this one, and take the reference down or up like this. It may be better now. So we have make this cube in the real dimensions of this car, and let's start by modeling this interior. So this is the interior of the car, and if you go, it may be that I must say that I haven't modeled this previously, but it may be a challenge to screencasting this series when you haven't done it before. And let's say, so I will start by making the doors, and the doors is pretty straightforward, and it's a simple بلين. So I will take this one and duplicate in shift D, and x axis separated by selection, and this one let's say go to isolate mode, control shift C to geometry, and if you go you can see that we have the windows and we have this and some handles. If you go to this one, so we have handles and some laser and any some real things. So we go to this one, and in here we have, you cut here and scale on Z to straighten this one. Let's say it will be here, and what I'm looking for is take these faces and extrude on X. Or I can take all the whole shape and extrude in X like this. And isolate. So now we you can see that this black shape, this the outer faces is black. So the problem is to control in, and you can use the shortcut or use shading and recalculate or flip. So recalculate will recalculate the normals. Sometimes you can see that the faces not drawing correctly, so you will flip direction by using selecting face by face. So we have done better up to this moment, and take this face and extrude in X like this again, and take these faces and take these ones also, and extrude scale shift X like this. So this will be the windows and the glass, and extrude or X to delete these faces. Select the outer edges only. We can remove doubles if there is remove doubles, not any doubles. So, and bridge edge loops, and control R like this, control B, and make something like this. And we can now shift D separated by selection, and take this glass which is the glass, and let's zoom to see this better. We want to this to be a glass. So how we can achieve this? We will, so we can, I say it's better to take these ones and fill, also these ones and fill. So we have, let's recalculate normals and control shift C on object mode to geometry. Let's hide or take these blueprints and move here. So we have this door, and this door up to this moment it's flat. So if we go to the this blueprints, we haven't done any handles yet. So I will make some edges here down in this one, and some a lot of edges here. Let's say it will be, so let's, so if you go to the blueprint you can see that we have 10 shapes or dividers in this blueprint. I will go here and make 10 loop cuts, and so we can take one by one like this and extrude on X, or remove doubles first, take these ones, all these ones, and also one by one like this, and extrude on X slightly like this. Again we can take these ones and go into two individual origins and scale shift X 0.9, it's 0.96. So the same process we will apply it to the remaining faces like this, extrude on X, but we want to be exactly the same dimensions like here. So activate the snap and go in GX like this. So scale, shift X. So we haven't done yet this this to better equally like this one. And the remaining part, which is the handle. So the handle is simply, let's say it's with screws, and we can make it better. So as I have mentioned, we will not make it the level of detail to be as much as it in the blueprint, but because we are going to make some blueprints, so it might be easier to make only the shape as we want. So it's because it's mirrored, so we will, let's make look at here and take this once and delete these vertices and apply the mirror modifier. Go to mirrors and apply the mirror modifiers around Y and take these ones. In the top view, we will go extrude like this and extrude again on Y and extrude final time. So we have this now, the handle, which is nice, but now it's very thin. So we will apply the solidify modifier. So now we are going to apply the solidify modifier, apply the scale, and the thickness, let's say it will be 5 millimeter, and take this to here, subdivision surface. It may be in the y-axis like this, and scale, push it up, and go to shading, and the shading will be smooth. In the x-axis, push this like this, and take these ones and extrude on X and scale on. So we have now make the mirrors correctly, the handles correctly, and I am going to apply the mirror and leave the subdivision surface and the solidify as is. So we have made the first door in this car. Let's see what we have later. We have this outer. Let's say we have this. We have this driver. I don't know how this mirrors can be. As you can see, it's very simple to, because it's mirrored on x-axis. It's we will only model one part and mirrored it on the other view. And so let's start by making this one. It's around, once we have make this one, it's very simple to finish this interior, and it's very simple. So we are going to a new layer, and let's say it will be in layer 2. And if we go to, if we go here and so I will take these faces and shift D and separate by selection, take these ones to layer, move to layer 2 and go to this layer. And you can see that we have so I will start by a cube, and this cube will center it here, or shift C and add a cube, and this cube will be here. So scale this down like this, and scale on Z like this, and we will add edge here, select this left one, and delete these vertices, mirror on the x-axis, and I see that now let's add edge loop here and take this. So we will take these ones and scale on Z like this, and let's redo this one, and we will take these edges and scale on Z like this. As you can see, we are now tracing this . So in as you can see in the y axis, it's very big, so we'll scale on y like this, let's rotate these edges and . So what I'm going to make is to make this first tab, which is this. You can see that there is a door, a roof. So I will scale on Z like this and take this one and extrude or inset and scale on X. Take this one, extrude on Y, something like this, and I'm going to take this shape, Shift D on Z, and separate by selection, take this one, Control Shift C to geometry, and extrude on Z axis like this. So how we can make this roof? It's very simple, by making a plane and scale down and go to the top view, align this properly, add two edge loop cuts, and again one here, delete this face. After you make this, you must delete this face, take all hand and extrude on Z. We can take these ones and pull it like this. So we have make this one. And so what is remaining is, it seems we have make this part, but as you can see there is a speaker here, so this speaker is like a circle, this circle 12 vertices and the scale down like this, and Rx 90 degrees, let's say it will be, go to the top view and extrude on Y, take these ones, extrude scale shift Y 0.8 and extrude on Y, extrude scale shift Y and extrude again final time on the Y axis. So let's recap this one by making fill, and let's join this one and join again to make these rounds. So I will go to enable proportional editing and start by smoothing, and G on Y, decrease the size by going to the wheel mouse, and let's say it will be like this. Go to the sphere finally, and G on Y like this. So we have make this beaker. We can smooth it by control 2 and go to subdivision surface smooth shading. In the render it will be a 3. And so how we can achieve, so I will not, as you can see in this one, in this beaker we have some details like this one. It can be applied by using a texture. So let's refinish this one, and in the other side we will mirror. It easily can be mirrored. Let's go to this one. It's very similar to this, but the front isn't, has some mini holes like this one. So we can reduplicate it or make one from scratch. Let's shift D and scale like this, and re-isolate again. So now we have reached to this point. How we can make the hole in this part? Add loop cut, and it may be better to how I can. So let's re-disable proportional editing and take these ones. We can again, let's control R and take these vertices forward, and the ones this to be in down, and take this face and X faces, is this edge W and the circle. It's not better, so we will apply the scale first, and let's try again to circle. So it's now better. As you can see, it's very realistic. And let's remove doubles and take this edge again. Extrude, scale, shift Y, and scale down. Take all these ones in the Y axis, extrude on Y like this, and fill. Take these vertices to make the geometry is a clean. So we will take these ones and join, and the remaining part is to take these ones, go forward in the Y axis to appear much more like this. So there is no difference, much difference between this speaker and this speaker. The only difference is the front, which can be applied by using texture. But I have said that we are going to render blueprint, not realistic render. So let's go to this one, which has some I see that this is a watch and some let's say it will be a refrigerator. I can't identify it will be, but we will model this. So we are going here in this one, and we will take this like this, take these vertices using C, select all, scale on Z by 0, and again this one here, let's see, it has not been selected. Let's say we have here again, we will select this one, the scale on Z 0, like this. So as you can see, we will take these two vertices in the front. Let's enable clipping, and in the front we will take these ones and push them down and go to add edge loop cut here, maybe one here, and let's say extrude scale shift y. Let's try, will it work? It can work. So scale on z and x faces, we have this one. So the loop tools, I must say the loop tools, if you will if you didn't find the loop tools, go to tools and the plugins and you will must enable this loop tools. And we are going to start by making it circle. So this is the watch, this is the watch we are going to make, and it's extrude scale shift y like this, push in gy, push some to some distance on the y-axis like this. And there is another extrusion on y-axis. And finally we will recap this extrude scale shift y and fill. So the only thing, we will take this edge and this shift d on y, separate by selection and enable the mirror modifier, take these ones and fill, join these two vertices and go to all and g on hide, g on y. So this will be the gloss of this watch. As I have said, we can apply this texture which is numbers and something. So let's go to the next part, which is this part. So go to the two front view and apply edge loop here. So let's start by making this ones. I will take these two vertices up to this size, and this face will inset like this, extrude on y, and we will make take this face and shift d on the axis, separate by selection and extrude on z, and center to be on geometry. We have make one scale z again, so we have make one piece. So let's replicate it, shift d on z, replicate it again, and shift d on z, replicate in again, and finally one part to here. Let's rearrange them like this. We can join all these parts, control J, and so I will select this circle which is in the watch, which is the mirror, and control shift C to geometry, and the name this will be a gloss of mirror of or any watch. And after joining these ones, we will apply the mirror to the gloss, and it's properly mirrored to the next side. And again, this one will be applied, mirror on mirror object will be a gloss, and it's around here. Let's continue, and we have now here this whole part. So how we can achieve this rule? We will go by taking an edge loop here, scale on z like this, g on z, and we can take some vertices one by one and move them in the z-axis like this, and all will be scaled on z. Another edge loop here, scale on z will zero, and take these ones, select them, g on x, scale x zero, and we will take all, select this one, and e and y, and back to distance, like let's say it will be 30 centimeter or something like this. And finally we will make the glass again, shift D, and on y axis up to this distance, and separate by selection. Let's name it a glass and apply the mirror modifier, and name this will be center, or glass at center, at center. And again there is a lot of details here, let's try to match them and select these ones. We have some details here, and these details will be achieved by making some loop cuts in an even distance, and this so we have some details. We will select these faces and extrude on Y again. We will shift D on Y and separate by selection, extruding, make let's see. So we can, let's see the mirror object will be a glass, and extrude on Y like this. Let's see what we have now. We have some details in the middle part, so we will apply also an edge loop here. And the first thing, let's rearrange some edges to be in even distance, and also in the back view we will take these edges, and let's zoom to a distance, and these edges will be separate from each other so as to make a clean geometry. And again we will take edge by edge and g on x axis. Alright, so we have done this part correctly, and the remaining part is this interior and some driver. And let's continue by selecting this, where is the faces, and these faces we will select them all. And first we will rearrange them by choosing this, all these ones, and so the next step is to make this close to each other like this. And we may add an edge loop here in this distance, take these vertices and pull them up, select all, scale on the axis like this, and it may be better to take and select these faces. Let's see in the blueprint we have. So we will select from here and select these ones in the wireframe mode and scale on x0. It may be better. So again the same process to extrude scale shift y 0.9 and extrude go to view and extrude in y like this. So what we have here, we have this one, and this inner part has shift d on y, and again separate by selection select these faces. And where is this? So I find it better to control shift C and to apply the mirror for this. Where is this? Apply the mirror and move, select all and move to an 5 layer, let's say 5 layer, and we will make sometimes making the details. So we have some details and some buttons and so on. So select edge here, scale in Z like this, and another scale in Z 0, and this will be the I can say the main part of this interior. And also again we have some edge loop here, scale on Z. So let's continue what we have left in this part. I can see this is mirrored in the x-axis. So I will select these vertices and delete, apply shift S cursor selected, and apply the origin to 3D cursor, add and mirror modifier, and we will start by taking these vertices, scale in Z0, making where is this vertices and extrude on y like this. Again we will select these faces, and selecting these vertices go here and take this one, delete faces, select this and convert to a circle by going to loop cuts and make a circle which is a flatten. And again we may find it's better, before we make this circle we will select this circle finally. And again let's refill this circle. What I'm going to make is to make these holes first. These details we will make first, because the circle will follow the geometry of the high detail in this shell. I can see that we have to select these faces and extrude on y something like this, and shift d on y separate by selection. So we have made someone like this, and let's try to, we will not making this part in now. So we are going to now to make this circle, select these faces and delete faces, select this ones and convert to a circle. So it's now perfectly a circle, and it contains 12 vertices. And again we will extrude on y like this, fill, go by 4 if you have the mouse wheel isn't correctly worked. So you can select this and join to make the geometry as clean as possible. So like this, we have converted it nicely to 4 faces each board. And again in here, as you can see, there is can be a switch for this core. So it can be done by selecting these vertices and Shift D on Y, separate by selection, again extrude on Y, and let's say it will be like this, and again select this one and extrude on Y. And let's see, so we have now make this switch, and what is the remaining? The remaining is these parts in the bottom, and this is in has been arrived. I can say it's in this part, not in this level. So it's in a level higher than the remaining part. As you can see, there is some inset here. So we will start by making these cubes first. So let's go here and Control R some points here and take these faces and delete. Or it's better to extrude them on Y to a distance like this. And again, let's delete these faces. So the remaining part is to add a cube here and scale down to. Again, we are going to scale this cube and scale on X, Shift D on X axis, scale something like this, scale this cube to some distance like this, and again Shift D on X. And you make sure that these cubes are bold in the y-axis to distance, which is, let's join them, select, and the face not in a distance on y-axis, much like this. So we have done pretty much 90%. The remaining part only is this circle. So let's start by inset, take these faces, and I must say that we can recap this so let's select this and inset like this, and X faces, let's try to convert to a circle, and R and scale again. So we have done this one. The remaining part, it's let's see, make it perfectly like the blueprint. So how we can achieve this? Let's go to cursor selected and say add a torus. Where is the torus? And this torus has let's say 12 and 12 like this, and scale, scale down, scale again, and r x 90 degree, r x 90 degrees, and let's say it will be like this. So let's rearrange this to be, I must now try to make it cleaner and smooth. So how we can make it? We will start by this circle and apply the smooth modifier, subsurface modifier, and go to smooth shading, and again and also for this one it will be a smooth and three subdivision surface, and also this one must be smooth shading, and you can see it's horrible and the shape isn't like correctly as we expect. The reason why is there is some faces here, and these faces can be done by selecting all and move faces and select these ones and delete faces, and we can now let's see what we have here in the blueprint. We have here some switches, and you can see some switches, and these switches can be done. So these switches so I will move this to a final layer and add a new cube here, and this cube will be the switch and the scale on X like this, and apply the subsurface modifier. Like this. It will be must be an smooth shading. The edge must be in the control E edge slide in the other side like this. As you can see, we are making high level detail, so we can select this one and shift D on the axis and push them on the side like here and scale on Z like this. Also there is some other cube here, so shift D on Z, scale on Z, and shift D on X. So we have and also we will make this cube like these ones have some inset and buttons like button. So how we can achieve it? Select this face and extrude scale shift Y 0.8 and E on Y like this. Also another time, extrude scale shift Y 0.5 or extrude in Y some another time. Apply subdivision surf, re-isolate, go here and smooth shading, try to make it like a cube like this, and let's see a smooth shading, and it will be in the view like this, but in the render like this. Control L object data and control L object data. So rather than making them or duplicating them, we have replicated the object data. So now we have make this part. As you can see, we will take this torus and mirror them, apply mirror to, let's say it will be to this part, which is, let's say it will be 12 or 112, and apply mirror modifier to be this time and apply. So these are now one object, and you can see, let's replace them finally to layer 2, and where is the car? So the car in layer 3, and let's take this and go to layer 3. So we have now make this one. As you can see, it's now, where is the glass? Which is the glass? So it says the glass at the center. Take this one and apply mirror modifier. Apply the mirror modifier around glass at center like this. We can now apply mirror. Nothing is hard. So you can see it's now very similar to the interior of the car, very very similar, and we can push them to a realistic later. But now let's start to make this driver or the other part. As you can see, this other part has different than this part, but let's try to make this part first. So how we can make this? So we will start by, let's go to a new layer and start here by making a circle, and this circle will have, let's say it will have, so here is two vertices and two vertices and two vertices. Let's say it will have here 6 vertices, and on the other side it will have 12 and another 2, so it will have, let's start by 16 vertices, and the radius will be 10 centimeter and R on X like this. And again we will select these ones and R X R Y like this. Select all and extrude scale shift Y like this, and we can take this and extrude again, extrude and extrude. On the other side we are going to take these ones and extrude, extrude on X, and again another time extrude on Z, G on Z, and extrude final time. So we will start by merging these things, merge at center and take these ones, fill this face, we can scale this to be perfectly like the blueprint, and let's start by arranging this. And the final step is to recalculate normals and extrude on Y like this. So we have now this handle and control 2 to make it a smooth shading. you can see that this isn't arranged correctly, so we'll select these ones and push them forward to like this. And the final step, let's make it smooth. The final step is to apply this C in the blueprint. So we have some details here, and I am interested in to making these details. So how we can achieve these details? It's very simple. So we will take this ones and G and Y like this, and also it will be G and Y, and all these E and Y like this. And add loop cut here. Dissolve edges. So as you can see, dissolve edges, as you can see, it's similar to the blueprint. So there is some handles here on the brakes, and you can see we must add some a cube and scale 0.1 or something like this. And this cube will be here or on Y like this, and we will select these ones and rotate and extrude another time like this, and rotate, scale and extrude another time like this. Control 2, and we will try to make it matching. I think it's not perfectly. And again, we will push them here and select this face, Shift S, course to selected. And add another cylinder. This cylinder will have 12 vertices, 0.05, 0.05, or on x-axis 90 degrees, and scale down, scale on Shift Y, and select all scale in Y like this. Control 3, we can apply smooth shading for these two objects, and now we have make it pretty much as the blueprint. But I am willing to make some changes here like this. As you can see, I am wanting, I'm willing to arrange them as you can see. So the next part is to make these two handles. So we will, let's duplicate, or we can start from a new cylinder, and this cylinder has 8, and let's say it will be 1 centimeter of depth, and R on Y 90 degrees. Scale again, and scale on X 10, scale, and one final time. So the next part is to add these ones, Shift S, course to selected, and add a plane. Again, scale like this, and scale on Y, move here. So how we can achieve this? Take these ones and again scale like this, extrude on x axis like this, and one final time. And as you can see, we will select all and extrude on Z. Take this and control B like this, and extrude scale shift X. And make the origin to not 3D cursor but 2 geometry, and let's isolate. I'm wanting to add some smooth shading here to make it like handle. Anything, we will apply the smooth shading and the view to be one. So this is the first handle. Again, we haven't make this to be like a circle, so we will extrude scale like this, or the best one to extrude scale 0.9, and take these ones and join. Where is the smooth? And select one in the view. So we will shift D on X axis and rotate around Z, or we can make them one object. Control J or Z like this, and another time or on Y like this, and it will be here. But as you can see, this is rotated something like this. So Rx, let's say it will be 80 like this, and it will be also Rx but not much like this. With the Ry, let's say 40, control J, Ry 40, Rx like this. And so let's move all them to layer 3 and push them here like this. So we have make something the next step is to make this part in the middle. So this part will be, we will try by making this cube in the middle. So I will select or shift C